Hello, I'm Tristan. For about as long as electric cars have been with us, the elusive idea of an electric car that can charge itself as it goes along has also been out there. Over the years, people have had different ideas of how to achieve, or at least come close to achieving, the perpetually charging EV. So far, the idea that has gained the most traction has been incorporating solar panels into an EV's exterior. But there's only so much space and charging capacity before you're back to square one. Now, another big idea that's got engineers' imaginations going is harnessing the power of regenerative braking. Could improving technology in brake energy recuperation actually be the key to unlocking the EV that can charge itself whilst driving? Let's take a closer look. If you drive a Tesla or another EV with regenerative braking, then you actually can charge your car while you're driving. Well, sort of. In simple terms, regenerative braking works by using your electric motors, or at least the electrical flow to them, in reverse to at least channel some of the reclaimed kinetic energy back into your main battery pack. Therefore, if you could engage the regenerative braking for any protracted period of time, that would essentially constitute a continuous stream of charge going into your battery, wouldn't it? Well, yes and no. Technically, regenerative braking does help to charge your Tesla or other EV that you're driving, especially when you're going downhill. There have been experiments done and shown here on YouTube where drivers have shown that their battery percentage actually goes up when descending long downward sloping sections of road, which is pretty cool. All these drivers do is get to these slopes and then let gravity do the rest. One YouTuber tested the effect whilst descending a 2.5 mile long downward road, wanting to see how much extra miles would be added to the car's range after all that. This regen braking experiment garnered an additional 3 miles onto the car's remaining range reading. So, if it works, why was my answer yes and no before? Well, you may have noticed that I started the previous point with the word technically. That's the key here. Yes, technically you are charging your EV when you coast along downhill using the regenerative braking like this, but there are two quite big problems standing in your way. Firstly, the amount of charge is small. Basically, the important thing to remember right now is that the amount of electrical energy that makes it from the electric motor back into your battery pack is quite small. We have to remember that we're working on reclaimed energy here, so it's all subject to the law of diminishing returns. An electric motor's current running in reverse, even using the most cutting-edge technology, is only going to be able to capture a maximum of 70% of the kinetic energy that is being given off. After that, more is lost as only a proportion of the captured energy makes it back to the battery, with some being lost as heat. All this time, your car is still expending battery energy just by keeping everything in your vehicle working. In other words, the heating or aircon, infotainment screens, the ancillary systems, they all still consume electricity, of course. The result? Well, those experiments that I mentioned earlier show real gains of miles and battery percentages. But what do these numbers really mean? The reality is that while your battery percentage number may jump up 2 or 3 points, or your mileage increase by 2 or 3 miles, those numbers can disappear just as fast, or even faster, than they appeared in the first place. Why is that? Well, that brings me on to point two, the return journey. You may have regained all that power going downhill in the first place, but what about when you're on your way back home on a return journey? You'll have to then travel up that same hill, likely expending all the energy that you actually regained, and then some. Even if you're coasting down a hill on your way home, thinking that you're getting a jump on your overnight charging, you likely had to climb that hill on your way to wherever you were going. Unfortunately, Tesla, GM, Ford, Honda, and other OEMs have yet to build automotive technology that can truly defy the laws of physics. Every action has an equal and opposite reaction. Except in the case of EVs, you might not find that it's so equal, and you actually end up with net losses, especially if you use a lot of EV downtime to run the Tesla karaoke system. Now, there's no doubt that regenerative braking will continue to improve, just as it has for the past few years. If you can cast your mind back to when this technology was only in hybrids, it was confined to hybrids, people hated it because it made the brakes feel a little bit spongy and even unsafe. It has since become far more refined and efficient, not to mention a great way to save wear and tear on your regular hydraulic brakes. As to its potential for developing the perpetual EV, it definitely has a part to play, but it likely won't be the definitive element that brings it all together. But who knows, with better integrated solar technology, enhanced regenerative braking, more powerful and efficient batteries, and some new innovations, such as wind capture, mini fission reactors, and of course karaoke power, we might just see the range of EVs massively increase. At the end of the day, we're still bound by the laws of the universe and the ever-present issue of diminishing returns. Charging on the road remains an elusive but desirable goal. Not because we should be building cars that run forever, but because we want EVs that can, you know, eliminate range anxiety and that better integrate into our new idea of more sustainable living. I hope you liked this video. If you did, please click the thumbs up button. Please also subscribe to my channel and click the little bell icon, which will notify you when I release new videos. Thank you.